Dear student friends, we have studied open sets and closed sets in a metric space. Today we shall study homomorphism of metric spaces and dense subset of a metric space, and some examples we shall see. I have written these results and definition to save the time. Now we will try to understand the meaning of these. So homeomorphism of metric spaces that we want to study. This is theorem, next theorem as theorem 14. The theorem states that let F be a 1-1 function, 1-to-1 function from a metric space M1 onto, it is also onto a metric space M2. If F has any one of the following properties, then it has them all. So that means all the three properties are equivalent. If it has one, any one, then it satisfies the remaining. Or they imply each other. First property is both F and inverse of F are continuous on M1 and M2 respectively. So F is a function from M1 to M2, and inverse of F will be a function from M2 to M1. So both are continuous. That is first statement. Then what the second says, the set G subset of M1 or is open if and only its image F of G, which is in M2, is open. So that means if F is continuous, I already proved these results. We have in the theorems on open set, we have proved this result. If F is continuous, then it sends open set to open set. That is, if G is open, then, or we have studied if inverse image of open set is open, that we have studied. But here both are continuous. F and inverse of F is continuous. So therefore both the results holds, and that's why it is if and only if. That G is open in M1, then, or if and only if its image F of G is open in M2. So that is the meaning of this statement. F sends, or F inverse actually sends open set to open set, and F also sends open set to open set. The third property is same about closed set. The set F in M1 is closed if and only its image F of capital F in M2 is closed. So that means if F and F inverse are continuous, then it sends closed set to closed set, or image of closed set to closed set, and vice versa. Pre-image of closed set is closed. So these three statements are equivalent, or if one holds, the other holds. So we have proved these results separately in open set and closed sets. Actually, what we have proved, F is continuous if and only if F inverse G is open in M1 whenever G is open in M2. And that is for F, but here F inverse is also continuous. So therefore, the both way relation holds. Open set is mapped to open set, and similarly the result is for closed set. Now we define what is homeomorphism. If F has any one of the properties, these three properties ABC, or hence it has all of the properties in theorem, this theorem 14, we call F a homeomorphism from M1 onto M2. So actually the definition is written in terms of theorem 14. But if we want to write it independently, then it is like this. If F is a function from 1-1 and onto function from M1 to metric space M1 onto metric space M2, and if both F and inverse of F are continuous, then F is homeomorphism. So homeomorphism means both F and inverse of F must be continuous. And what is F? F must be 1-1 and onto function. So also F inverse. So that is the meaning of homeomorphism. If F is a mapping from metric space M1 onto metric space M2, which is 1-1 and onto, then it is, and it is continuous. If F is continuous, inverse of F is also continuous, then we say F is homeomorphism from M1 onto M2. And the two spaces, metric spaces, are called homeomorphic. So this is the meaning or definition of homeomorphism of metric spaces. And now the examples. Examples of homeomorphism. So these are also easy to understand. So what we have written here is the definition of homeomorphism. And that the meaning is, this is M1 metric space and this is M2 metric space. F is a mapping from M1 to M2, it is 1-1 odd. And similarly, inverse of F is 1-1 and 2. F is 1-1 and odd. And both F and F inverse are continuous. Then we say it is a homeomorphism. Now we consider the example of homeomorphism. The metric space, this is closed set, 0, 1, closed interval, 0 to 1 and 0 to 2 are homeomorphic with absolute value metric. That means these are closed subsets of R1. And these are homeomorphic because to show the two metric spaces are homeomorphic, we have to establish a 1-1 onto mapping. And that also satisfies both F and F inverse are continuous. So here the function is defined as f of x is equal to 2x, because it sends the interval elements or real numbers in the interval 0 to 1 to 0 to 2. So each real number from this M1 gets double in this M2, and therefore the function defined is f of x is equal to 2x. Then this is 0 to 1 interval, so that is a closed interval 0 to 1. And this maps closed interval 0 to 2. So the image of 0 is, see, by this 0 again. So 0 is mapped to 0. And what is here, the element is half. Half is mapped to 1. And 1 is mapped to 2. And likewise, the remaining elements will be mapped correspondingly. So this is a 1-1 onto relation, and both way. So its inverse will be defined from this. Inverse of f of x is equal to half x. That is pre-image of 2 will be 1, 1 will be half, 0 will be again half of 0 means 0. So thus this establish 1-1 and onto relation, and both we know this is a simple function, it is continuous polynomial function. 2x and half x, both are continuous. So, and therefore this is a homeomorphism. Homeomorphism, not homomorphism, but homeomorphism from interval 0, closed interval 0, 1 to closed interval 0. That is our first example. And what is the second is f of x is equal to log x. And then this is a function considered, and it gives a homeomorphism from metric space 0 to infinity, means positive real numbers to whole real number R1, is an onto homeomorphism. So it must be homeomorphism. And what is the inverse of this? Inverse of logarithmic function is exponential e power x, and that is a homeomorphism. So it can be checked. Likewise, it is 0 to infinity means positive real numbers. For second example. Infinity. Here it is actually this is open. So 0 to infinity. And this M2 is negative infinity to positive infinity. Suppose like this. And or you may consider this as a positive infinity and this as negative infinity, and 0 will be middle point. So this gives f of x, because it is necessary logarithm of positive real numbers is only defined, and therefore it is taken as a 0 to infinity maps to minus infinity to infinity. So actually f of 0 means log 0, and we know log 0 is negative infinity, so this is mapped. And what about say if we consider log 1, then log 1 is 0, it is mapped to this, and log infinity to infinity. So in this way, the every element of this is mapped to unique element in this, and therefore the function is 1 1 and on 2. Likewise, the inverse exists. So both here it is f, and this will be f inverse. F is log x, and f inverse of f is e power x. So these are examples of homeomorphism of two metric spaces. Then this metric space is homeomorphic to the second metric space. Now after that we shall define the next set or subset of a metric space as dense. So let M be a metric space, the subset A of M is said to be dense in M if closure of A is equal to whole of M. Closure of that set is entire metric space, then that metric space is dense. Or A is dense in M if every point in M is a limit point of A. So then that set is said to be dense subset of metric space. An example of this can be considered as examples of dense set. So I shall consider examples here, examples of dense set. First, we shall have the open interval. Let A be the open interval 0, 1, and M be the closed interval 0 to 1. Then we have closure of A. Closure of A is the closed interval 0, 1. Closure of this open interval is the closed interval because it contains all its limit points. This set does not contain all its limit points because it does not contain the end points. And therefore a sequence, we have stated this earlier, sequence of points in 0, 1 interval which has limit 0. And then that 0 is not, 0 is limit point but that is not in A. And it contains the end points also, therefore this is closed set, and closure of A is this one, and we have is equal to M. Therefore A is dense in M. So that is simple example. Now let us consider the subset Q of rational real numbers R. The set, let Q be the set of rationals, then Q is subset of R1. And now we know that a sequence of points, the rational numbers, a sequence of rational number has a limit as irrational number, or that can be considered in other way as if X is a rational number, X belongs to R, then a neighborhood of X, then this neighborhood X minus epsilon and X plus epsilon. So this is a X rational number and this is real line. So if you consider a small neighborhood of X of see the interval is epsilon, x minus epsilon and x plus epsilon, and then this certainly contains an irrational number. So and that is irrational number, that is real number. So therefore the closure of Q is the whole real number set. So or we can write that there is a result, every sequence of contains this contains an irrational number. And so therefore, or in other words, that is a sequence of rationals has a limit of has limit as irrational number. As an irrational, or that means real, it is part of real. And therefore, closure of rational number is the whole real number. And therefore, Q is dense. Dense in R1. That is our second example. Now, third example can be considered as let A be a subset of R, discrete metric space, and we have closure of A is equal to A itself, because in discrete metric space every singleton set is closed as well as open, that we have studied, and therefore closure of A is equal to A. And but if A is not equal to RD, A is a proper subset of RD, then A will not be equal to RD. Then closure of A will not be equal to RD. So therefore, a subset of RD, proper subset of RD, is not dense in RD. Is not dense in R. So this is an example which is not dense. And why this is written? Because every singleton set in RD is closed. Therefore, closure of A is equal to A. So thus, this is about dense set and examples of dense set. Now we shall consider examples from exercise. So this is an exercise from the book Methods of Real Analysis by Richard R. Goldberg. First example we will consider is a finite subset of a metric space is closed. Whatever metric space it may be, and that is closed. So this we shall have to prove. So solution for this is, let, see, we may consider A be a finite subset. Finite subset of a metric space, yeah. Then A contains finite number of elements, say x1, x2, up to xn. Then this A can be written as, then A is, we can write it as a union of these singleton sets. x1 union x2, etc. up to xn. Now we have proved earlier, or we have seen earlier, each singleton set is closed, and union of, this is a finite union of closed set is closed, and therefore A becomes closed. So since each singleton set is closed and finite union of closed set is closed, this theorem we have proved, A is closed, which is finite. So this proves the result. It is simple. Now the second one more example we shall consider is, let A and B be subsets of a metric space here. if A is subset of B, then closure of A is subset of closure of B. This is the result. So solution for this can be considered as, we know the relation between set and its closure. A is subset of closure of A, and that happens for B also, any set. B is subset of closure of B. And what is given? A is subset of B. If A is subset of B, then we have the relation like this. A is subset of B and B is subset of closure of B. And this proves A is a subset of closure of B. That is, thus A is subset of closure of B. And closure of B is closed set. Also, closure B is a closed set. Or therefore, closure B, or we can write, therefore, closure B is a closed set containing A. Containing A. But we know that the smallest set which contains A is closure of A. As this example we have seen, what is closure of A is this interval. Only the endpoints are included. And this is the smallest set which contains the open interval 0 to 1. So that means closure of A, if you consider closure of A, and that is the smallest set. But containing A. And B bar is also a closed set containing A. So therefore, this is smallest. This is the smallest. Both contain A. B bar contains A. A bar contains A. But A containing A bar. But A bar is the smallest. And in this B bar and A bar is the smallest. And thus, or hence, this A bar is smallest, and that is contained in B bar. Both A bar contains A and B bar contains A, but A bar is smallest. So this proves the results. So thus, this is about a few examples we have solved. Remaining part we will continue next time. Thank you.